Hey guys, it's Nitro99 again, doing a new LEGO review on the Iron-Man Extremis Seaport Battle. It's $25, $20, $20 to $25, somewhere around there, or up to $30. It depends where you live. 195 pieces, 3 new minifigures. I shudder to say new because Iron Man's in every set since it is Iron Man sets, but he has a different costume in every one. So it is a new figure. And there's only 3 Iron-Man 3 sets, and 2 of them are elite. Not that expensive, and the other one is kind of more expensive, and it's pretty. It seems these Iron-Man sets very, like, I don't know, just lacking something. I'm not sure exactly. But this one actually comes with a comic, which is always fun. So there's Tony Stark and Peppermint Patty. What's her name? Ketchup? I'm not sure what her name. Flapjack? I don't know. I can't remember. I know it was something funny, stupid. Anyway, so they're like, you know, yeah, I'm not going to say what they just did. There's a helicopter and Mandarin. Even though he has 12 magic rings, he has to use a helicopter to get around. He also has a butler. And, wow, I guess they were finishing up their math problems. And, yeah, helicopter explosion. Duh. It almost looks like he's actually making her reach for him so he can rescue her. And then, oh, another missile, oh dear. She figures out to use the suit, okay. It's interesting to note that the suit actually has a little white thing there, even though it's in his chest. And, yeah. I don't know, there's not much going on, there's no dialogue. Peppermint Patty saves him with her suit, which is his suit. I don't know how she got in it. I mean, is it even fits? It couldn't even fit her. She's a different height. I don't know about that. Oh, and then now over here, War Machine is bullying this poor dude. That's just mean. And then he picks up a car and flies it, throws it at him because he can control cars. He's obviously a transformer. And War Machine uses his super sight. And then he's they're both looking like that. This looks so silly. And he sees dynamite in there. Oh my god, look at this. Look, he's a creeper. He's just creeping in there. Oh my god, this isn't even a review. This is just me looking at a comic book. Okay, so it keeps going silly and silly. Okay, let's get on to the review. That was way too long. It was just, well. Okay, so on to the review. I have to put an annotation at the beginning. Say, hey, this is where the review starts. This is the first figure. It's Iron Man Mark 42. Come on, focus there. Focus. Yeah, I'm not sure how he got the Mark 42. Like I said in my review yesterday, which if you missed it, check that out. It's on the other small Iron Man set. But this looks fantastic. It seems his suits get nicer and nicer. He's upgrading all the time. He's like a teenage girl. And is the face a little different? I'm not even sure. I'm getting kind of confused with all these suits and faces. I'm not sure if the face is different. I don't even have the other figure next to me because I just expected that, this is going to be exactly the same face. But I don't think it is. He looks scared and then he looks kind of cocky. Before, I think he had his mouth not opened. But, you know, that's a cool figure. I mean, I kind of feel bad for the people who aren't able to get all these sets. And they really like Iron Man. But there's so many Iron Mans to get. It's not like Batman, you know, he only has like 2 suits. This dude, Aldrich Killian, apparently he stole some serum that Tony Stark made, because Tony Stark is a genius, that allows him to control machines, which is how Tony Stark, apparently some very good commenters yesterday and subscribers told me about this, he can control machines. His head glows in the dark, which is pretty cool. It's actually just pure white. It kind of looks yellowish, which I thought was like greenish-yellowish, but it's actually glows in the dark. And I just put that extra blue thing there, and I gave him a super wrench because he needed something else to, you know, fight with. The torso is pretty nice. It's basic, and you can use it for other things. And he doesn't have any red stuff on his face. Otherwise, but his face isn't. I guess you could use it for a zombie. Everything I say, use it for a zombie. It's not very useful for anything else. And War Machine is probably the reason you're going to buy this set. It is unfortunate that you have to buy figure sets just for figures nowadays. It's like action figure collecting. But War Machine looks fantastic. His torso could be used for a ton of things. He could be like a Halo Spartan. He just looks great. He has a little cannon on the back. I'll take off that in a sec. Nice silvery shine. And the guy, his name's Rhodes, something Rhodes, the same last name as me. He's the black guy. He's Colonel Rhodes. He looks pretty nice. It's not a reused face. It's a brand new black person face, which is, in my opinion, great because I always like getting more. He looks really menacing there. He looks like, I just took off his helmet earlier and I just thought he looked perfectly fine without his helmet, except for the fact that he has a double-sided face, but I mean, he just looks like some kind of super soldier. And look at him, he just looks tough. And there's his back. Pretty nice. I mean, it's the best figure. It's one of the best figures out of the new superhero line, in my opinion. Even the Batman ones included. I think this guy is probably the best. One of the best. He's just very unique. And he's not flashy. I don't like superheroes that are flashy and red. I mean, when I think superheroes, I think stealth. That's why I like Batman so much. So anyway, you get this boat. I thought, well, this boat is going to kind of look stupid. It's okay. It doesn't look that stupid. It has... you'll be pleased to know that LEGO has been advancing in their flick-fire technology. They just put such a dedicated team to work. It's like a double-barreled shotgun now. This is how they made it. A double-barreled flick-fire missile shotgun. Look at that. Isn't that genius? It's genius. It doesn't fly very far, unfortunately. But see, it never ceases to amaze me how much effort LEGO puts in to make their flickfire missile technology the best in the market. Other than that, yeah, I can't say much else. There's a little hiding spot here. You put the dynamite, which doesn't seem very safe at all. There's a lot of depth. You can put like two figures in there and hide one in there. It could be like a Mexican drug running cartel in Miami. Use your imagination. So this could definitely work in Lego City, because you know Lego City is this crime-ridden cesspool of debauchery. Anyway, I think I actually like this set more than I forgot about this thing. This thing is stupid. I actually like this set more than I thought I would, because I thought it's just a boat. But no, it's more than a boat when you have imagination. But this thing is just stupid. It's the worst part of the set. It's actually 17 pieces. It's just put in here for filler, just to put the pieces up, because otherwise it would be 178 pieces, and that just doesn't look very good when you're paying $25. But 195 pieces is a little bit better, and this is what you get for it. It says JC82 on both sides for some reason. I don't know why. It doesn't even look like a buoy. It looks more like a oriental shrine, because I'm playing Sleeping Dogs, and they have these health shrines you're supposed to collect, and it looks just like this. It does not look like a buoy. I've never seen a buoy like this in my life. In fact, this one would probably top over. But anyway, it's supposed to explode, because it's completely useless. I don't know. This is a complete filler. But I actually like this set. I'm not going to get the bigger Iron Man set, but this one is probably my favorite Iron Man set. I actually like it more than the Avengers sets, just because, I don't know, it just seems more fun, I guess. Doesn't seem so, I don't know, action-packed. I'm not sure what I'm saying. I just like it. Is that good enough? And Marvel, it doesn't show any other sets, just the comics. Well, back here it has a bunch of figures. There's those Spider-Man sets I have to get. I'd really like the figures. It's sad to say that I'm getting sets for the figures. But I guess that's what everyone does nowadays. And well, this review really went on. I don't know how I talked for 9 minutes, but I did. If you've actually been watching this long, you'll be excited to know that I will be doing a contest very soon. Very, very soon. It's on one of the sets that I just got, as you saw my haul video. I'll be giving away two, or maybe three sets. Just kind of pick up again, because I've been gone for so long and just not having been doing anything. I just feel like a jerk. So I should do a contest and give back. That's what I'm doing. So I hope you enjoyed this review. It's a long video, but hope it was entertaining. And see you guys later. Until next time. Bye.